After having done our final testing, we want to export the data to look at it. So where do we do that? We can either do it on the dashboard and click data, or up here in the ribbon and go to export forms. Now there's two types of exports you can do. So you can export forms or export cases. The second one we'll discuss at a later stage. And then there's a bunch of different formats that we can export into. So we can do CSV, which stands for comma separated value. We can do Excel, or we can do what's called Excel dashboard integration. But let's just start with a simple form export. As you see, I already have an export set up. But since we added more questions, it's probably actually better for me to just delete this old export and create a new one. Because look, this is all here. We can see all the different questions, and they're all in chronological order. So they're not alphabetical order; they're chronological, which should hopefully help you more easily be able to find the columns that you need. And then here we can see all of the columns that we added, or questions that we added, since after the export. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm just going to, there's two options. I can either add these columns in, which if it's just one or two, that's fine. I could just say select all. But what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to delete this old one and then create a new export. So to create an export, I go to create new export. I need to select my application, which is the ComCare Basics. Then the module, which is the health facility module, and then the form. So this is easy because there's only one of each. And I see that I have 9 form submissions. Then I'll say create export. And then we choose the default file type, which is Excel. Now up here we see the export name, and very handily it gives us the application, module, form, and then the date of the export. Such as here. So sure, we can automatically convert dates and links for Excel. And then I usually leave these checkboxes unchecked. This is what the sheet name is going to be. We can just leave that forms. But you could change it. So we could change it to, for example, initial assessment. So that if we were to export multiple forms at a time, we know which is which. Then here we have 2 more options. So we can show or hide advanced questions, which are questions like this. It's the labels. And then as well, we have some other data here, which again, usually we don't really use. So you might want device ID or app version. Those could be very handy. User ID, if you prefer that rather than the username. And some other advanced questions. But usually we don't add these. And then the deleted questions, we can show the deleted questions. Then just need to refresh the page. And then if we scroll down, we can see that we deleted one of the repeat lists. But we don't necessarily want our deleted questions to show up. But luckily, they're very handily marked. So we just don't select them. OK. Then here in the display, we can say use either question labels or question IDs. So currently, it's going to export the IDs, which for our Power BI purposes, is what we want. We could also display the question labels. But I would advise against this, as you know, it's going to come up as specify other and here we're going to have specify other, and here we're going to have specify other. So it's going to be impossible to know which, for some of these questions, where do they belong in the survey and what do they refer to. So we want to really keep our question ID so that we know exactly where in the form these questions are located. Okay, and then let's scroll down. And remember, in one of our videos, we created a repeat group. So repeat groups, they come up as separate entities. So I'm just going to select this. This is going to be the sheet name. It's going to be repeat list of other specific charges. And then I need to manually select all. And this is because we're essentially creating a one-to-many relationship. Right? So we have our original form, and then within the form, we have an unknown number of questions that are constantly being repeated. And we'll see in the next module on Power BI how we can link these two forms together. And then obviously we're going to ignore this deleted question. Okay, so after all of our settings are correct, we need to change the default file type to Excel 2007. Make sure we have this selected. One final consideration to make when creating your export is at the bottom here we have our privacy settings, and this button here allow me to mark sensitive data. So when clicking this, what it does is it adds a sensitivity column. And what can we do with the sensitivity column? We have a number of options. We have none, we have sensitive ID or sensitive date. So what does this do? Well, for example, we are recording a name here. So we're recording the name of the person in charge or the contact person. Now, in this case, it's probably not a big deal and we can, you know, leave that information as is. But you might be interviewing beneficiaries for a survey, or you might be doing some case management in a child protection project. And in that case, when we create the data exports, we might want to keep in the names for data analysis purposes, but actually de-identify those names. So how does that work? Here, for example, we say this is a sensitive ID. And so what it'll do is it'll create an ID, so a random number. But if we have certain names repeated, it'll repeat that same ID for those names. Or here, a sensitive date. So, you know, we also don't want to be in a situation where we can use somebody's date of birth, for example, to identify, you know, who this person is and what they've answered in a survey. In that case, we might choose to have a sensitive date, and which means, if I'm correct here, that it'll create a random date within a band of 1 month before and 1 month after the actual date. So it'll randomize that date to a degree. And then we can go ahead and create our export. Great, so now we have our initial assessment form export here. And again, we only have to create this once, unless we're going to, of course, add a bunch of new questions to our form. If not, we only need to create this once. And then once we have new data, we just click on export. Okay, so here we can add some filters. So we can choose the groups or users. So I just want to return all mobile workers, and then a date range. And this is standardly set to export all data. You might only want recent data for the past week or so. Then you can also just click on here. And let's say like last 7 days, last month, last 30 days, or a custom range. Okay, I'm going to say prepare export. And download. I'm going to open up the file. And there's our data. ready to be analyzed in a very nice and neat tabular format. So another option for creating exports is this Excel dashboard integration. And you know, we're actually a step further than that. We're Power BI dashboard integration. But either way, what it does, it creates a HTML table, so a web-based table that our Power BI dashboards can easily access and query. And it refreshes that table every 24 hours. So let's take a look. So ours is a form in the ComCare Basics, health facility, and initial assessment. And then we're going to say create dashboard feed. Okay, so same thing. So this time we obviously cannot select our file type because the file type is given. Then our sheet name we can change again to initial assessment. And the rest is very much the same. So we see all our questions. There's the deleted option for deleted questions, which we don't want. We're going to select this repeat, and then we're going to select all the questions within the repeat, and then we're going to create it. And there we go. And so what does this HTML table look like? Well, first we need to update the data. So this ensures that we have the latest data. Then we need to just refresh our page. And sometimes this happens. It doesn't immediately update, or you need to wait a few seconds. And hopefully now when we refresh our page, there you go. Okay. So we can say, see here when it was last updated. So by definition, this updates every 24 hours. But if you need more recent data, you can always just come here and say update data. And then here is the actual link to the dashboard. So if we copy this and just paste it into a browser. Oh, that didn't quite work out. So this is what it looks like. So we can see there's two tables here. This top one is our regular form. And this bottom one here is our repeat. And the in Power BI, it's very easy to choose either one or the other. And so this information, again, it updates every 24 hours. Our Power BI dashboards query this HTML table. And again, it's only accessible using your username and password. And that's what we'll see in the next module as well when we try to read data using Power BI from this link. It's going to ask us to enter our username and password. So it's all very much secure. Then there's one more thing to show you here in the export. In this export video, you can do a bulk export. So if you have a bunch of different forms and you want to export all of them, I can just go select all or the ones that you want, say export, prepare the export. Download. And now we see our different forms along the bottom here.